tell you about in relation to children and adults, and in courses, I'm going to tell you about the structure behind books and how they work. I'm going to tell you about the work that I've been doing over the last 2 years in the adults and 1 year in children, about simply how it's worked. Really struggling with care, very loyal to family, very much at risk of losing their family. Only 13 years old. And incredibly hard to have a conversation about how to keep it safe. So I was talking to one of my independent communities today about children. She said, I know if the regulations are right. This is just very briefly a way of saying there is underpinning statutory guidance and legislation for both the children's board and coming up very shortly for the adults board. And there are independent agency bodies that are supported to any other body. There are relationships between the boards and other aspects. Just to give you a flavour, here is the children's. Safeguarding children for something. challenges that they face in modern society are very different, I think, to the children, to the children. And sometimes we don't always recognise what's different for them. Particularly about my daughter yesterday, when the tiles were in, she was she came from school and they said, "Do you mind letting the brush that were outside to me?" And obviously, over the years, I've not introduced that concept to my daughter that I'm very used to. A household brush, you brought down a hairbrush. So I think you know, this is something that is always, you know, a reason we need to be aware. It's not one of the concepts you would need, but there is expertise to support you. This practitioner event just shows you, look at the picture of that, how much activity, how busy that was during that event. So it's very, very busy. A lot of people really, you know, wanting to be aware of how they can improve their network, how they can link in much better with partners and relatives. Serious case reviews for children are an area where we have a requirement in statute to undertake them where there is a child who suffers significant harm. There is a question about the partnership function behind supporting that child who is enabled. Better, and we're all familiar with some of those national stories. What we are recognising in terms of priorities, we're wanting to ensure that the message gets out. So, review undertaken, we understand what went wrong, but do practitioners, not just those involved with a particular challenge, also understand what went wrong? So that's step one. Step two, which is the challenge ahead, how do you make sure people change the practice? So I was going to go through a few. We've got a range of lessons here in this particular one, but it's just an example of some of the work that's going on to make sure people understand clearly. gone this way. I think one of the things that I understood, a colleague of mine was to some taxi drivers, and it was around the time that they were open, so it was a bit of a fallout about Liverpool taxi drivers coming over to Europe and having some room to collect their fares and things. So it was quite a lively group when we went in. And the discussion was, are they aware that this is an issue? Could they be picking up some of the people? We weren't sure whether they were staying in the room with you at this point. Upset by the early discussion, but when we got to this, my colleague said that the decision should be quite high about doing something. And that was on the back of our hunting badges, and we can also on the side of the camp, who we bring, what else can we do? We'll do the online training with taxi drivers. Online training, it's fantastic. And if the reach is out there enough, if we connect with some of the wider group of people in the community who can support our own people. Really encouraging. Okay, just a couple more priorities for children. Monitoring and improving functioning of the board and its challenge of trust. We have a joint event now between trust and the board. We're really useful that work is facilitated. We have our independent chairs who attend the children's trust. So there's work going on around that. And that's been a criticism from Ofsted inspection of the authorities previously. And strengthening joint working between two people, which I'll mention a bit more. Okay. Going forward, 2013-14, here are our priorities. I'm not going to go through them other than to just describe one or two, because it is obvious to you what they are. I think the first one is, as CSC we talked about, neglect. Clearly, see the same thing when we go in the house. This is the point where we need to intervene, whether you've got our agency or our profession. Learning and improvement is really about that serious occasion and other types of really work, bringing out emerging learning. And having getting a different response from the workforce, we don't want to shine away because they feel criticised and good by the review. We want them to come back in and recognise what we can get out of the process. Signs of safety is a strength-based approach to working with families. It's a whole program that's held in national. It's a really good approach for actually getting in and working with families differently. There's an immediate safeguard that's to each kid at home. Okay. So the Safeguarding Adults Board, called the Safeguarding Adults Partnership Group. What have we been doing over the last year? Well, there's been a lot of work around policies and procedures around safeguarding. And that's been about a partnership set, a set of procedures that show what the pathway is when you get a safeguarding consent to your attention. And tells you what your role is in the world. And that sounds fairly simple, isn't it? It's quite complicated. And you can end up with a lot of handoffs. Forty agency training, actually getting out and making sure those policies and procedures are understood, and people know what they're looking for. Structure and governance, that's the new structure that is revised, and it's designed to strengthen the arrangements. And quality assurance and performance framework, and that's very much within the authority at the moment. What we want to talk about is how we make that more partnership. Stage one is getting accountable. We know how we're getting on about this, we know how fast we're going to go. Now then, is that visible in the back? You can see that just about. Not a surprise, these are safeguarding alerts. That's when somebody contacts the central advisor duty team and says, I'm worried. I'm worried somebody's either at risk of harm or and this is 2012-13. You see, the biggest group is actually the residential care staff. It is really a goal of vision. last year, 2013 to March 2014. You can see again residential care staff numbers are high. We actually had 100% increase in the number of students, 2,662 alerts during in the period between April 2014 and March 2014, which is a similar number in here. And this is attributed to better awareness. What we're not saying here is there's more things happening that will save our nation and others. What we're saying is better awareness, better understanding. People are more confident about having health and then we'll save
our nation. Also, I think this is actually one.
Yes, it would. It would. But we might get there. So we have a conversation. Okay, maybe safeguarding personal, that conversation we had earlier about us having a room about children and the voice of the child. I don't know whether you people saw the documentary around protecting parents where the couple were at home in their late 80s and were very dependent on the children. Together 6 years, she has been moved to hospital and he was saying, I cannot be here without. They're always ringing the ambulance over everything. You can see what's on the telephone. They ring the ambulance up when they've got an issue, and he rings up and says, "It's my heart. You know, we need to kind of hold it like this." And they're saying, "We don't know what to send an ambulance." He's just missing it, that's what he means. And so, making safeguarding personally is actually really making sure we understand what somebody wants from a conversation, from a disclosure. Being alert to a risk, what they want. It doesn't stop the police moving in and we've got a serious threat. This is about people in a relationship who want to have a say in how we conduct what we do. And the national work we were part of was having 14 authorities nationally last year. And this was some of the feedback. It's a person-centered outcomes led to people feeling more secure. Strong engagement from partners, and this is a bit of an unbearing reason why it was, but we have more attendance at strategy meetings nationally around this approach than what people do previously. People don't want to be made, confidence in social workers, we feel we're doing the right things to talk to first, and more effective safeguarding, we actually reduce. So this is an approach that we're adopting in Wirral this year. This is the unit that sort of sits behind that I manage. We have our local authority designated officers in the application of safeguarding professionals. We have a board manager. We have a lot of training and development and support and drive the MSP program. It's a bit too competitive rather than a little bit. It's a gold, silver, and bronze. Development stage in children's. To be honest, it's an interesting treatment now. So they're a bit more focused around functioning and counterfeiting. I wanted to strengthen the arrangements between the two boards. And this is at an earlier phase, I think, developing a system for completion of case reviews, because again, it's going to be recently becoming statutory. We're all going to be involved, the board's been involved in consultation and statutory guidance. And now we want it to be very where the interview is a bit more material. And I think they're actually a bit more over here, but they're not confident enough to recognise that. So it's not just about knowing what to do, it's actually being confident in what to do. The green implements, you know, the robust policy assurance framework and separate, that's about partnership and partnership. And developing a communication and meaning strategy. So that all of you and your communities know what. Or don't you or your communities know how you can get involved in one of the things? And also, it's clear to them some of that around the performance side, to make sure the information about safeguards is specific to the areas of your community. Finally, towards greater working across your families and well-being. So, the things that are facilitating that, helping that. There's one of me, and this one isn't here. There is one independent chair, and that's happened in many places around the region, both children's and adult schools. We want to look at the opportunities for collaborative training. Police will say, the lobby goes in, the council goes in to a home where there's some safeguarding issues, and there's a child in the corner that's seen. So how do we make sure that collaborative training starts to help people look and think as a we've got our joint group establishing our joint subcommittees, we've got one around domestic violence, which is just starting. We've got a system about learning and improvement, so that framework and training as and we've got some joint areas of work, and that should be one of them. And I think CSE will be another. And that's about that kind of concludes what I want to say headline-wise about the report. I can read it and ask some questions about step down on what appears once in the past. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
One of the things that has been marked on, not just here,
engagement with the family at the outset and understanding what it is we are asking them to do differently to alleviate professional concerns and what support they need is a real art, and that's why we believe that the Science of Safety program, which is a well-researched, tried and tested approach, brings together a number of approaches, really, from things that people have worked with before, to one that is really suited to managing this. So an example of a similar one is found in group conferencing. You may have heard of that. That is where it's an approach where we actually give the task of coming up with a plan of safety to the family. It's not as regularised as it could be for this group of children because of the sheer numbers and the time involved. But Signs of Safety go some way towards doing that. So we would expect to see, as we introduce this, both professionals involved and social worker and the conference chairs, a change in style, approach and methodology. It would be more embracing of what the family has and our strengths behind those upfront risks that are concerning us.